Wisconsin Extension Local Government Center's program on parliamentary procedure for local government. Have you ever been in a meeting where somebody offers a friendly amendment? What exactly is a friendly amendment and what do you do about it? Today we're going to learn about the procedures, the proper procedures for amending a motion that is pending. So let's see how our board does it.
We are now ready for the next agenda item, which is the parliamentary procedure training.
I think this is important, and the Local Government Center has a workshop scheduled for next month. I think that if we sent the clerk to that workshop, she could bring back the materials and fill us in on the important stuff. I move that we instruct the clerk to attend next month's Local Government Center's workshop on parliamentary procedure.
I second.
It has been moved and seconded. We instruct the clerk to attend next month's Local Government Center's workshop on parliamentary procedure. Is there any discussion?
You know, if we ask the clerk to go, we're going to have to pay for that registration fee. Eileen, would you accept the friendly amendment that the motion specifies that we pay for the registration fee?
I'm sorry, Eugene. While agreeing to pay the registration fee is a good idea, it's really not up to Eileen to agree to change the motion. Once I, as the chair, have presented the motion to the body, then the motion belongs to the body, and the body alone decides whether to change it, even if the changes are relatively minor.
That can't be right. Friendly amendments are made all the time.
So, who's right? Yunji or the chair? They can't both be right. So is the use of a friendly amendment proper procedure for amending a motion? So to get the answer, let's hear from Larry Larmer, UW Extension Local Government Center's expert on parliamentary procedure. So, Larry, what's the answer?
Well, Dan, in this case, the chair is correct. It is not up to the person who made the motion, offered the motion, to decide whether or not to make that amendment. The idea is this. There's a thing, a principle here called ownership of motions. And once the motion is made and seconded, and then the chair presents the motion to the body, it now becomes the property of the body. So it is the body's decision whether or not to make suggested change in the motion. Not up to the person who made the motion anymore.
So do we have to have a motion to amend in all these situations?
Not necessarily. Sometimes that suggestion called friendly amendment could be made, could be relatively non-controversial, maybe a clarification or something of that sort. And if that's the case, the chair can try to get the decision made whether or not to make the change through the process of unanimous consent. So the chair would just simply say, it's been suggested that we make this little alteration in the motion. Is there any objection to that change? And then if there is no objection, the chair can simply order it done and the motion would be changed.
So what if someone objects?
Yeah, well, then you can still make the change, but you do it through the formal motion process. So in that case, the chair would probably say to the person who made the friendly amendment, who offered the friendly amendment, that we can't do it by unanimous consent, but you can still move to amend the way you wish, which of course would require a second and then ultimately a vote on whether or not to make change.
And it just takes one member to object because we're looking for unanimous consent. Is that the notion?
That's right.
All right, that was a nice explanation. So let's go back to our meeting and pick up the action right before Yunji disagreed with the chair. And let's see what happens now.
Yunji, I will ask the body if there's any objection to making the changes that you suggested. And if no one objects, the motion will be amended to specify that we will pay the registration fee for the workshop.
What if someone objects?
Well, then you could offer a motion to amend that would require a second and majority vote. First, let's try the informal approach. It has been suggested that the motion to send the clerk to next month's Local Government Center workshop on parliamentary procedure be amended to include a provision that we pay for the registration fee. Does anybody object to making this change? No? I hear no objections, so the amendment will be made. The question now before us is, the clerk shall be instructed to attend next month's Local Government Center's workshop on parliamentary procedure, and the board will pay the workshop's registration fee.
So Larry, did the chair handle the unanimous consent properly this time?
Yes, indeed they did. And of course, we remember if they hadn't been able to get unanimous consent, then they could have gone through the formal motion process. It's important to note that whether the amendment is made through unanimous consent or whether it's made through the formal amendment process, the chair did the right thing by restating the motion as amended so that everybody then would know exactly what they're going to be deliberating on.
Okay, then, no more friendly amendments. We want to have friendly board members, but not friendly amendments. We're going to use proper procedures from now on, as you just learned in the video, of how to amend a motion that's pending. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.